final question. It's integration, but it's also a bit of differentiation, because to find the area under this curve, we're going to need to split this into two. So we've got this bit here. Now we can use definite integration to find that area there, but this area here is just simply a triangle, and for that we know that this point here is 4, 6, so we know that's 6 high, so we know that the height is 6. We just need to know what the base is of that right angle triangle, and for that we need to know what the gradient is. You could work out the equation of the line, but it's not actually important, because once you know the gradient, you can just work out what that intersection must be. So to get the gradient, we need to differentiate what we've got there. So I'm going to start off by writing it as a power of x like that, to the negative 2, 3x take 8, and then differentiate that times by negative 2 gets us negative 64, drop the power by 1, plus 3, x drops off, and the constant just falls away. And that is going to be what we now need to do is find out what the gradient is when x is 4, because that point there is the point 4, 6. So when x is 4, we're going to get dy by dx is going to be minus 64 over x cubed. So that's 4 cubed plus 3. Well, 4 cubed is 64. So negative 64 over 64 is negative 1 plus 3. Negative 1 plus 3 is 2. So the gradient of the curve is 2. So as that is perpendicular to, it says line here is the normal to C, so normal to it means perpendicular. So the gradient or m of L is going to be negative a half. So if that's negative a half and it's going to go down 6, it must have gone along 12 beforehand, because 6 over 12 is a half, isn't it? It's going down. So it's gone along 12, so that'll be 16 there, but the important thing is that that length there is 16. So if I call this bit here, they called the whole thing out, so I'm going to call that T for triangle, and I'm just going to call that bit there U. So then I can say that T is going to be base times height over 2, which is 36. So that's 36. So now all we need to do is show that u is equal to 10. Well, we need to start off by integrating that. So we're going to be integrating 32x to the negative 2 plus 3x take 8 dx. And we're going to be doing that between the points 4 and 2. So next up, we raise the power by 1 to negative 1 and then divide by the new power. So 32 divided by negative 1 is negative 32. Then we raise the power from 1 to 2, divide by the new power. So that'll be 3 over 2. And the 8 becomes 8x. And we don't need to worry about the plus c, because we're doing this between 4 and 2. So what that means we now need to show is just substituting 4 and 2 into there and there. So 4 into that will go negative 32 over 4 plus 3 over 2 times 4 squared. Take 8 times 4. And taking away from that will be all the same idea here. So negative 32 over 2 plus 3 over 2 times 2 squared. Take 8 times 2. And if you put those bracket bits in there, you do need to show, because it says it, you need to, they need to show you the method. We need to show the method all the way. Where you could then put that into the calculator, and that should give you negative 16, and we're going to be taking away from that negative 26, which is the same as saying negative 16 plus 26, which equals 10. So that was u is going to equal that. So u plus t equals 10 plus 36, which equals 46, which is r. And it's all done.